Initiative Podcast. I'm Waz3323.
They call me TV Dex.
I bought a soul healer.
And I'm Healed Fiend. It's a Saturday, April 27th. So how's everyone doing today?
Not too bad. Kind of tired though, if I'm being honest.
Busy week?
Busy work week, lots of gaming, boosting, and whatnot. Pretty stressful week too, if I'm being honest.
Oh, what happened?
Nothing that I really want to get into besides work being just hell. But that's about it. Also, people are way too needy. You people need to leave me alone. Okay?
I'm not
No.
needy. I'm not needy at all.
Some
Oh,
of you are very needy.
needy.
No, I actually had a pretty busy week too. So I put myself through a lot of punishment. It's the first week of the baseball season. Get to be a coach, and for some silly reason, I signed up to be commissioner again for the second year of our Double
Wait,
A
hold on.
League.
Are you coaching your kids' baseball team, or is it like a work thing?
Oh, it's not a work thing. It's the kids.
Okay.
So it's only one of the twins this year. Last year it was both them, but one of them he doesn't really like sports or baseball or
That
anything.
that's
So
kind of odd.
it must be rewarding.
I find that odd that they don't want to
Well,
do the same thing.
they are very, very different people. It is really amazing. So
I had a friend,
that's a
I
good
had
thing, yeah.
a group of friends that were triplets throughout basically my entire like elementary through high school life period, and I never saw them separate from each other. They were always together. They were always wearing similar clothing. They were always doing the same thing. That's the only experience I have with twins or triplets or anything about that.
We made a conscious effort when they were born to, now first of all, they're identical twins, so to us, obviously we can tell a difference. They look very different to us, you know, that are around them for the last 12 years.
Sure.
But to everyone else, well, no, we did wonder when we took them home from the hospital if we ever confused them. We left their ankle bracelets on for a good 3 weeks because we were worried that we were going to mix them up. You know, and that, you know, this
Nice.
one's not really this one, it's the other one.
Yeah.
But no, so I mean, but we made a conscious effort when we brought them home is to not treat them like they're the same person, to give them their own identities. And, you know, a lot of it with twins especially, it is environmental. You know, it's, yeah, you're born with similar or the same pretty much DNA, but we treat them like they're two individual people. We always dress them differently. They go to the same school, but we made sure they're in two different classrooms, so they're not in the same classroom together. We praise one of them, we scold the other, you know,
Yeah,
good
that's a
stuff.
good thing in my opinion. Definitely.
That last part,
No, all of it.
all of it.
Like, you basically treat them like their own people. Yeah, individuals. That was the
Individuals.
word I was looking for. Thank you, Water.
Yeah.
But yeah, anyway, what about you, Healed? What have you been up to this week? Okay.
What are you studying again?
Geology. Basically, I want to do paleontology stuff, so I'll just be Indiana Jones, but with fossils.
That's awesome.
Or you can be what was Sam Neill's character in Jurassic Park?
Also a paleontologist. I just forget what.
You can scare little kids
Ian.
with Velociraptor.
Yeah. That sounds like a wonderful job. I would love that.
Who wouldn't
Scary
want
little
to be in
kids.
Jurassic Park?
Yeah, scaring little kids is kind of a lot of fun.
Sounds horrible.
We already knew Healed was a terrible
Don't tell me
person.
you don't scare your children, was.
All right, so what else has been going on? Water, what'd you do this week?
I have had an extremely busy week at work. I've had, well, I've done 4 days this week. Doesn't sound a lot, but I've had three containers come in. One of them was 8 hours late, which is nice of him. So that puts us beyond by a good day's work. But that's all caught up with, which is nice. I've not got as much gaming done as I'd like. But, you know.
I've gotten a lot of thinking about gaming done. Does that count?
Yeah, I mean, there's a process behind
some
it.
Some weeks, but... that's all you can do. Just think about games. It happens.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Like, I thought really hard earlier in the week. I was like, ooh, Assassin's Creed Odyssey, finally done. I turn on my PlayStation. Nope, still in the same spot.
Didn't they just add DLC to that game this week?
They always do. There's trophies in that game that you can't even attain because it says it's in there and it says trophy coming soon.
I've never seen that happen before.
They did that.
No, never.
They did that. That's kind of one of the. I'll say it's the opposite of an incentive, but I'll phrase it as incentive for me to not finish the game at the moment because I can't get those trophies. So I want to finish the base game, get the platinum. Get the DLC at least that I have that's free, and then delete the game so I can go play a different game and fit it on the hard drive. But I know that if I finish it completely, I'll have 3 or 4 trophies that I'll have to wait a month, 2 months for, however long until they decide to add them. And we don't even know what they are. They can just decide altogether. It's like, yeah, we're done developing.
Well, awesome. That's kind of what I did with. Origins. Like I was really looking forward to that game. That was the first Assassin's Creed game that I was excited for. But I knew they were gonna add a ton of DLC and it was gonna be really spaced out, so I just waited until it was all out there and then I went back to it.
Yeah.
I'll probably go back to it at some point. It's just for Origins it's too expensive right now for the DLC. I know they had it on sale, but it was still, I know, you just roll your eyes, but I mean, it was still $30.
Wait, what?
For all the DLC.
No, I got it for
$12. Yeah. Why'd you do that?
They have the season pass for sale in the start of January for $12.
Thanks for telling me.
I didn't know you back then.
No.
Oh, okay.
I'm sure it'll be on sale again. They do a lot of Assassin's Creed sales recently.
Yeah, they do. But I'm sorry, Waz. You know what? I'll go back in my time machine. And I'll find your boosting session from January. I'll enter it, and I'll make sure to tell you, hey, download Origins Season Pass. It's on sale.
You can't go back in time. Crazy person. It's not
I'd like to
we're,
think...
we're not having the time discussion right now.
Well,
I was gonna get out my inner Stephen Hawking.
No, we're not having this discussion. We've had a similar discussion in the past, and Waz didn't go your way, so... I said,
how did that go my way?
You thought Wazer would be on your side, and he wasn't.
Hold on, what was this argument?
You asked us if we could press a button and go into the past or go into the future.
Oh no, that was just philosophical, not
okay,
practical.
I know, but it had to do with time, and you lost. So.
Well, that's because water is unpredictable.
Yes,
because
he is his own man. But you expected it. I can go find it in the chat.
Thank you.
You said, I already know how water will answer this. But Dex, I'm curious. And then you asked me the question. And then water ended up answering the opposite of what you thought.
Well, I'm sorry that I predicted my BFF wrong.
Good job, water. You are an individual.
Yeah.
You don't have to succumb to Waz's rules.
It's not my rules. These are society rules. All right. Anyway. All right. So, I guess, what are you guys playing right now?
I just finished playing some Burnout Paradise Remastered with the group. Got those 8-player trophies. But besides that, obviously Battlefront 2. That's the game that we're all boosting together and playing legit. And I've been playing Naruto Ninja Storm 2, which actually I have a history with. That was the first game I ever 100%ed, but that was on the 360. And so I've wanted to go back and get it on my PS3, get that platinum. And so I'm very close. I beat the campaign, I did all the multiplayer stuff. I just need to do all the like side events and grind out some money. But yeah.
Well, oddly enough, to piggyback on your week, you talked about Burnout Paradise, which, by the way, is, and I, it's hard to explain why, like me personally, why I like that game so much. But it's a fabulously well done game. But oddly enough, as far as anniversary you go, Burnout Paradise for PS3, that was my first platinum.
Oh,
That
nice,
back when they
nice.
invented
That's interesting
platinums.
how that worked out.
Yeah.
What?
Did you have fun? Did you have fun at least playing the? I know you only played for probably like half an hour, or
I played
were you
some
max?
last night while I was doing the intro. I do like the game. Now I've liked the Burnout games since like the PS2 games, so I knew I was going to like it. I generally don't like racing games. But I like the open world stuff where you can just kind of drive around, do whatever you want type of thing. I don't like the Gran Turismo, more simulator type of racing game.
Oh, I love Gran Turismo. I learned how to drive by playing Gran Turismo too.
What, you mean
No.
drive in
See,
real
I can't
life?
get into racing games.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Well,
I remember when
that's good.
I was driving and I was commented that I was a better driver than other people, so I at the time, right? And so I look back and say it was because of all my time playing Gran Turismo 2 on what was that, PS1?
I think it was PS1. Because
Yeah, I
four
don't
was
remember those.
PS2. I think 3 and 4 were PS2, I think.
Yeah, something like
Yeah.
that. I played a lot of them on PS2, but I didn't play any of the PS1
Well,
games.
I live in New York, so I don't
I
need
just
to
remember
drive.
I just closed my eyes and just pictured that game, listening to
Okay.
one of the songs they had in there was Garbage. Only Happy When It Rains. It was
Okay,
perfect,
okay.
perfect.
This is to anyone that's 16 years old and about to learn how to drive. Don't listen to Woz. He just said, I just closed
What? What? No.
my eyes.
Yeah,
Don't
don't
do
close
that.
your eyes while
Don't
driving.
do that. That's a big no-no.
Would you rather learn how to drive? Well, first of all, you don't know how to
I know
drive.
not to close my
So.
eyes while I'm doing it.
Oh, sure you can. Sure you can. Isn't that, yeah, that's how, was it Reno 911 Miami? I think that's how the movie opens up. The guy in the driver's seat wakes up. He goes, I just had the most wonderful dream. And the guy next to him goes, you know, you're driving, right?
Hey,
A great opening scene.
Jordan's gonna be learning how to drive soon. He might be listening to this. You don't want
Not.
him listening to this, I'm telling you.
I told him that. I told him to go play Gran
You told
Turismo.
him to close his eyes while he's driving?
No, not
Okay.
specifically. But he
No.
can if he wants, just not when he's on the road and not when the
Jordan,
vehicle's moving.
if you're driving your car, even if you're just behind the wheel in the garage, do not close your eyes. Don't listen to your father.
So who hears, by the way, we'll take a segue from Gran Turismo into what is soon to be coming next year of the PlayStation 5. Who's going to
Ooh.
buy it day one?
Probably me. I bought the Xbox One day one. I regret that, but.
Yeah, that's Xbox.
That's a good
So
point.
you're allowed to regret that.
I'm just upset that I guarantee the day it comes out, I'm going to have all these kids tugging at me, wanting that. It's like, we just got PlayStation 4s. We just bought those.
Well, the good thing is the backwards compatibility, so it's not like you need to keep the PS4. You can
I will
actually go
guarantee,
forward.
I guarantee though, they will make you buy Fortnite all over again.
Fortnite's free.
No, the save the is it the save the world? There's something
Yes,
that costs
that
money in
mode
that
you
game.
have to buy, but like, do your kids actually play that mode, or do they just play the other one?
I
I'm pretty
don't
sure they
know.
play the
That
other one, the
they
one that every kid plays, and that one is free to play.
but about also the one that you buy, it comes with different skins and dances and all that, and that's I think more what they care about.
Well, from my
Yeah.
understanding,
Yes, I probably paid 40, 50 bucks a kid just because they want silly dances like the
yeah,
Carlton and
but
all that. All
for
right,
hold
but
on,
that's a
from
lot of
my
money.
understanding, everything that you own digitally is going to carry over to the PS5. As long as it's from the PS4. PS3 and before that, I'm not so sure. But PS4 stuff digital will carry over.
That said, they also say that anything you buy digitally on a PlayStation, anyone that plays on that PlayStation, assuming that you have PlayStation Plus and has access to the internet, anyone that plays on that PlayStation can also play it. Fortnite is tied to your profile. So I've had to purchase that game 3 times now.
That might be the exception to the rule. I don't know, but
okay. Right. So all I'm saying is I know I'm gonna have to buy that.
But I'm really still gonna
just
be on
so
that
know,
game.
That's all they play. That's all they play. I bought them the Sims 4 because it was $8 a couple weeks ago. They played it for a day, and then back to Fortnite all over again. I have to give Realm Royale credit. It actually kept their attention for 2 days.
That was a great game.
I highly
really enjoyed
disagree
that
with you. Realm
well,
Royale is not...
let's be fair. Let's be fair. I was the best at being
you
a chicken.
Were.
You were very good at being
there's
a chicken.
There's no question of that. I survived the longest.
You are.
Right, I think in the Guinness Book of World Records for gaming... I do believe, yes, Water, that you broke the record for the amount of times in a match as a chicken that would come back and without having to be, what was it, resurrected?
Yeah.
In the game.
With the res scroll, yeah.
I mean, I don't know. I just developed some crazy skill somehow. I don't know how I did it, but...
The res scroll? Wow, someone's an expert there.
Anyway, back to the PS5. So, are we all getting it day one?
Depends
I'd like
on how
to
much
think
money
I am. Yeah.
I probably
would.
Okay, why? So are you getting one day one, or are you getting five, like you have to put the PS4?
I will not be getting five. There's a chance that I'll be getting two.
Okay, and...
It depends. If... They're definitely... I'll say this. I would say, yes, I would want to get a PS5 day one, but if the launch titles... either aren't that great or they're already dual system, then if there's not a whole lot of incentive to buy it day one,
let's talk about the rumored launch titles, at least from Sony's perspective. I believe I heard rumors that the Horizon Zero Dawn sequel is supposed to come out within the first year of the PS5. It could be a launch title, maybe not. I also heard a rumor about the next Gran Turismo game being a launch title, and the...
I haven't played the last one yet.
That's on you.
That is another game. I pre-ordered that game, 2 years ago now? I still haven't played it.
Well, that's on you.
But you know what? That Steelbook is very pretty.
And the other one that I'm hearing rumors about... is, and this one I actually see being true because we haven't heard any information about it, but it's Ghost of Tsushima. It's supposed to be a PS4 game, that's what it was announced as, but there's no date for it, no year for it even.
I've seen videos of that game. What's its close resemblance to a game
that's kind of a combination of Sekiro meets Assassin's Creed, but it's not supposed to be as hard.
I was going to say, so it's super difficult.
No,
and it takes
Sekiro in the sense that it's a
forever to
samurai game. It's like that point in time, that genre, third-person samurai game. But it's open world, and it's more like Assassin's Creed, where you have areas that you have to defend against, and there's some sort of main storyline with the character who's trying to get retribution or something like that. I'm not explaining it very well. Honestly, we don't really know that much about this game. They didn't show too much of it. They didn't talk about it too much, but it looks interesting.
Well, I just wonder if it was another pretty-looking game that's almost impossible to play for people.
It doesn't look difficult. No, gameplay-wise,
it
looks pretty good.
It's made by the same guys that did Infamous, I believe. Yes, Sucker Punch. Yeah,
this isn't super hard.
Sony doesn't make games like that, besides Demon's Souls, but that's only because they own the IP for Demon's Souls. So they don't really make games that are super difficult. I don't have to.
Yeah, can we get another Infamous game? That's what I want. And I don't want Second Son. I want Cole back.
Well,
Bring Cole back.
Well, I don't think you're getting another Infamous game for a long time. So.
Yeah, probably.
You're not getting Cole back. It's not going to happen.
I'm sad.
So are you guys at all interested in talking about the PS5 specs? Like how strong it's going to be, how fast it'll be?
I am curious if there's any more news that's come out. I've kind of lost track of it over the last couple weeks.
I don't believe there's been any news about, you know, like the graphics card in it or anything like that. What we know is it's going to be a next generation graphics card and a next generation CPU, which is a good thing. With the PS4, the main problem is the CPU. It's incredibly, it's like ancient. It was ancient when it came out. That's how bad it was.
Well, they probably got it on
yeah,
sale.
Yeah.
So they.
It will be comparable to a mid-tier gaming PC, which is a good thing. Like that's what you would want out of a console. When the PS4 came out, it was comparable to a lower mid-tier PC at the time. So this will be a bit better. I think 4K still won't be the standard across all games. I think we'll still be seeing a lot of 1080p games.
By the way, who here has a 4K TV?
I have one in my house, but I don't use it for gaming.
I don't have one.
Okay, so I'm going to be in the minority on this, and people will probably be like, oh, okay, you're blind. I have a 4K TV. I have a PS4 Pro. I cannot tell a difference playing a game in 4K.
What games have you tried playing?
Other than the fact that it loads Horizon Zero Dawn,
okay, that's,
specifically.
Yeah, that's
supposed,
a big one, yeah.
It's supposed to be really, and HDR, all that stuff turned on. It looks nice, but the price difference that to get that kind of rig going versus just having a 1080p 720 is a little too low, but a 1080p flat screen TV with just a regular PlayStation, there's not much of a difference, at least to
Plus,
me.
It could just be that you're ancient and your eyes are just not what they used to be. It's possible.
But my eyes are not what they used to be. That is correct. But no, I'm not. Well, hold on. Let me clarify. You can tell a little bit of a difference. At least I can tell a little bit of a difference. But when I'm saying if I go to just watching television, for instance, and you know, even though there's not a whole lot of 4K channels that are out there, if you switch over to a 4K channel, night and day different between a regular channel, which through I won't say who I got TV through, but it's not really coming through quite on 1080p anyway. It's probably more of a 1080i or probably 720p. But either way, it's night and day difference, 4K. I'm saying when I'm playing the game, I think the PlayStation itself does such a good job of graphics that I can't tell a difference between what is normal gaming for a game like that.
There's two reasons for that. First of all, even though you're playing in 4K, let's use Horizon Zero Dawn as an example, the textures that you're seeing are not high quality textures. So, and that's because of the RAM limitations in the PS4 as well as the CPU. So you're not getting the same 4K image that you would if you were playing on a high tier PC. And the second thing is you're not even seeing real 4K in most games. It's they call it checkerboarding, basically. They get a set resolution, let's say some weird resolution, let's say 1600p, and then they upscale it to 4K. It's not real 4K. That's one of the reasons why you don't notice a difference when you're playing a game, but you do if you're watching a 4K Blu-ray or a 4K channel on your TV.
Right, that's a good point. So I guess as far as 4K is concerned for a PS5, if a game's actually designed that way, that it's supposed to be 4K, and maybe it's downscaled to everyone that doesn't have 4K, maybe there is a bigger difference. But I don't know, I'm not sold. Did they say they're gonna do like 8K even?
See, they did say that. I don't see that happening. I think maybe for like movies, like streaming movies and stuff like that. I just don't see it happening for gaming. I think it's just like, it's.
I couldn't even imagine. Okay, so my internet, just like my cell phone, we have data caps here. I couldn't even imagine how much data I would blow through just watching two or three movies in 8K.
I mean,
I'd probably be like, well, hopefully you didn't want to use the internet the rest of the month because we just watched a single movie in
the thing
8K.
is, I don't think that TV producers like LG and Samsung want to make the jump to 8K yet. And the reason I say that is because this is something I read, I don't know if it's true, but theoretically, the human eye can't see beyond 8K. So, wouldn't that be the stopping point, like in terms of TV upgrades? So wouldn't it want to milk 4K as much as they can before they move to 8K? I'm sure there will be something, TV and VR in like 15, 20 years, but I just don't see 8K being a thing right now.
I wonder if 8K will be the same thing as 3D, where it'll be a feature in TVs, but no one buys it. They're just gonna buy the cheaper end televisions that
Yeah.
don't have it, and eventually just dies
I
out.
mean, do we really need.
You know, which by the way, I mean my TV's the one that we have, our main TV that's 4K and all, it's 3D as well. We've watched probably five 3D movies on it, and that's it. We've had the thing for 5 years.
Really need 8K though? Like, in America at
No.
least, 99% of TV channels are in 720p. In Japan, they have 4K channels for TV. Like, it just comes with your standard package. We're not caught up to that yet. We're not even at 1080p for TV yet, let alone 4K, and they want to go to 8K. Like, just it makes no sense to me.
Well, yeah, I think DirecTV touts the most 4K channels, and they have three. They have a documentary channel, which is interesting if you like documentaries and things. But there's only so much that you can. I shouldn't say documentary. It's more like nature kind of stuff, which really shows off 4K really well. There's a live channel, which is good when they actually have events, but they don't have them all the time. But you know, yeah, you might not care about some low-level college football game with two teams that you normally wouldn't care about. Watch that in 4K, you're much more interested. But it's not all the time. And then the last one's pay-per-view. So, but and it's been that way for years. And they really have. I don't think they've had the incentive to add more channels because the demand's just not there.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I think they can still
And
milk
then just like.
4K. Like, I don't think we're moving on from that. Not yet.
Probably not.
Regarding the PS5, the last thing is Sony confirmed that it will include a disc drive. And I think that was a little jab at Xbox because they had just released their discless Xbox One S, which people have dubbed the Xbox SAD. Because it's the Xbox One S All Digital Edition. So,
I get the theory, and I don't think it's a bad one. And unless I'm wrong about something, what I don't understand is they're only t I know the parts, you're not saving that much money, but it's like $50 less, I think, right?
From the standard S, I believe so, yeah. At retail, it's $50
Yeah,
less.
so you save $50. I think there's going to be a couple of problems they're going to learn. First, I would rather pay, if you're already going to pay a couple hundred dollars for something, wouldn't you just want to spend the extra 50 just in case you get a disc someday? I mean, I don't think $50 is enough of a price difference to me to justify having something that is technically perceived as a lower qual, has less
Yeah.
features, right? But the thing that I don't understand is, are there really that many people out there that are just buying an Xbox now, or even a PlayStation, I should say, that at this day and age that are only going digital?
I don't think so. And
No.
I think this goes back to one of your points you made about 8K. Like, people still live in areas where you have a data cap. So, yeah, you save $50 when you buy the Xbox One SAD, but think of all the money you'll have to put in when you go over your data cap limit, and you gotta pay that
Oh yeah.
fee.
I mean, I know I was joking about it sarcastically, but when we were playing the PlayStation Plus Conan Exiles game, and I just did the math on it, I was like, oh, that's 8% of my data cap. And that's sad. It's sad that I downloaded
That's a
a game
lot.
that all I was downloading it for was to get a platinum trophy in like an hour and wasted 8% of my data cap. Now, granted, we don't use it up during the month, so it's not like it was there, but it's electricity, it's all just for a silly trophy. But it's like 8%. That's a lot. I know it was
I
a
take
big
offense to
game.
that.
What?
There's no silly trophy. There's
Silly
no such thing as
trophy.
a silly trophy.
No. Every trophy special.
Yeah.
It is when the game takes up almost 100
Hold on,
gigs.
Water. You live in the UK, right? Do you guys have data caps on your internet?
Not that I know of.
So it's just a US thing, I guess? Because I know Canada
Yeah,
doesn't
I
have
mean,
it, I don't think so, at least.
we do get like on our phones like contracts, you get data. But if you got Wi-Fi, you don't use
Yeah,
data at
well, I'm
all.
talking about
So, but if you go
your like
over,
house internet.
you do get charged. No.
Okay, so it's just us.
But
I mean, I don't
there's a
even yeah.
good there's a good reason for that too. Like Dex, you live in a really, really high population area where there's a lot of competitors, so they can't get away with that. Whereas where I live in the middle of America, if I want high speed internet, I have one person I can go to.
The guy down the street.
I have one. Pretty much. No, I mean it's the cable. It's through the cable
I thought you were
company,
talking about
the
stealing.
local
I
cable
thought you were
company.
talking about stealing cable from your neighbor.
Now, I don't know their password. I cannot get their
Ha.
Wi-Fi. But
It
no, but
was.
that's the thing. It's all about
Yeah,
competition.
definitely.
Is they can do whatever the heck they want. And people complain about the price. It's expensive. People complain about it. It's like,
It's
well, what
only when
else
it
are you gonna
got
do?
worse too, so.
Yeah. Who's your cable guy? Is it Jim Carrey?
I think that joke went over my head.
You've never seen
It's a
the
film.
cable
I've never
guy.
seen that movie. There
It's a
are a lot
must-watch
of
film.
movies that you guys have brought up that I've never seen. I think I have like a list of 10 of them already.
Yeah, but you are a
I
bit younger
think
than us, though.
we
It's well
could
worth a
fill up
watch.
one of these podcasts for an entire 24 hours just going over three or four movies, just going back and forth with quotes from the movie and just reminiscing how great they are.
Okay, so I'm gonna have to
Yeah.
be absent that week, and the reason is because even though I watch a lot of movies and I pay attention, I am really bad when it comes to quoting movies. And this goes with songs too. Like, you know how some people can recite an entire song, like the whole 4 minutes of it? I can't do that. I'm just really bad remembering quotes.
I don't know. I have a index of a memory, so I can just pull pretty much anything from it.
Okay, robot.
So I was going to reference a TV show that probably none of you have heard of, but like my mind seems to work like the television show Dream On. It was an HBO show from the I was on the 90s, right? Yeah.
Never heard of it.
It wasn't a very good show,
No.
but that's okay. But the concept of the show, I think it was one of the first shows that had, and I'm probably getting this wrong, but at least in my memory of the shows that had those just quick 2 second flashbacks, like a Family Guy, if people watch that where they have those just segments like, well, Peter will reference something and then they'll do a cutaway for like 3 seconds to something that he's
Right, yeah.
referencing. The show Dream On did that very well. And the concept was that this guy, he's now an adult, he would have flashbacks to his childhood that his babysitter was much like the cable guy, his babysitter was the television. So he'd have flashbacks to like other TV shows and all that. That's honestly how my mind works, except most of the shows that I reference in my mind are The Simpsons. So I have every single episode and line from The Simpsons archived in my brain. That every time someone says something, oh, there's a Simpsons reference. There's a Simpsons reference. There's the greatest show ever. Dex, you need to catch up now.
There's a
I'm
lot of
watching it
Simpsons
bit by bit,
references.
and yeah, I mean, South Park did an entire episode about The Simpsons because The Simpsons did everything. I don't know if you guys watch South Park, but
it's a great show. Yes,
have you seen the episode about the Simpsons? Yeah, that one.
Where Butters or Professor Chaos keeps getting annoyed because he comes up with concepts where Simpsons did it.
That was a great episode. I struggle with the first few seasons of South Park. It's a bit too silly. Like the first episode with the probing. But if you get like to season 3 and 4, it starts to get really good in my opinion.
I think I'm one of those weird South Park fans that I think the show has gotten better, because they've gotten away from the singular throwaway episodes, and they've gotten to more of a season that the episodes are all have a theme to it. Short of this last season didn't really have that, but the probably the previous 4 or 5 before that, they had a theme that was going on, and it felt like that the creators, was it Trey Parker, Matt Stone, are doing a really good job of building on a storyline, but meanwhile doing their theme of the week.
I definitely agree with you. It's only gotten better.
We're probably in the minority on that one.
I think so, because I started watching South Park, had to have been at least 10 years ago, and I started watching it because that's what everybody was watching at the time. But I feel like I have no one to talk to anymore about, you know, the weekly South Park episodes. No one knows what's going on. Feels like a lot of people have dropped out.
I'm here for you.
Well, I didn't know you up until like 2 months ago, so. Alright, I guess we're talking about TV shows and movies anyway, and the big movie that came out this week is Avengers Endgame. No spoilers, please. Have any of you seen it?
Okay, I'm going to spoil the movie for everyone.
Oh no.
Okay. Close to the end of the movie, these words start scrolling up the screen. No, I haven't seen it.
Oh my gosh!
I did have an employee though. I did have an employee that had to take off early on. Was that Thursday? Yeah, Thursday. So they go to the.
I don't blame them. I mean, I'm nowhere near caught up to Endgame. I think I'm right after. I haven't even gotten to Infinity War. Is that the last Avengers movie?
That's a great film.
I think I'm up to Doctor Strange, and I like whenever I feel like watching a Marvel movie, which is like once a month, I'll put on whatever's next on the list. So I'll get to Endgame probably around December. Have you guys seen the movie yet?
That's probably when I'd see it.
So none of us have seen it yet.
No, God.
Well. At least we can't spoil it for people.
We're a bad group.
Yeah, exactly. I want to see it, but like the tickets were so expensive because it was like the fastest selling pre-ticket sale movie ever, and I am completely broke, so I can't pay for tickets anyway.
Yeah, it's apparently breaking like every film record known to man.
It's supposed to be the biggest grossing movie of all time.
I don't think I'll see it until it comes out to rent or stream or anything. Well, I can't stream it because it'll go against my data cap. But to rent it, because we just can't go to movies anymore.
I heard it's like 3 hours long.
I went to Shazam last week. No one tell me how the second half of the movie is. Never seen it. Saw the first half. Daughter kept complaining. I had to take her outside. We took a walk for an hour.
Well, why did you that take your 2-year-old chance. Daughter to see Shazam?
First of all, she's 3.
My bad.
She likes the pretty colors. His suit is really colorful.
Oh my god.
Now, we had a little bit of an argument beforehand that she barely sat through the Lego movie, the second one. So I didn't think she would sit through Shazam. She did good for the first 20, 30 minutes.
And then... How is that half the movie?
she'd walk out to the lobby, and then we'd have one of our kids go out there with her. Then they'd bring her back, and then she got bored again. So then another kid would take her, and then eventually I just went out there with her, and because she was just so restless and complaining, and she was trying to talk, and She was being a 3-year-old, basically. And then we got scolded by the movie guy. That was great.
Ooh. Lost got in trouble.
That's well, gotta hurt.
The movie is rated PG-13, so maybe a kid her age wouldn't sit through it. I'm like, yeah, I know.
Captain Obvious.
Yeah, he offered to give him my money back, so he goes, you can come back later. And I was like, I don't want your pity money. Leave me alone.
I don't take handouts.
All right. Well, I think we've covered most things, right? I forgot one big thing that I know none of you will care about. Last of Us 2. They finally finished shooting all the mocap. My fingers are crossed. I'm hoping that game comes out this year. For some reason, none of you have played the first one. I'm very saddened by it.
I played the first one. I stopped playing the first one.
What is wrong Same. With you yeah. people?
I did two playthroughs and...
Hold on. You did two playthroughs of it? Like, two entire playthroughs?
Okay. Yeah. Two entire Lager's playthroughs.
Lager's my new best friend in this group. The rest of you suck.
I did two playthroughs. Playthrough equals an hour each.
Yeah, you suck.
I played the game for a couple hours.
I did two playthroughs if you mean turn the game on twice.
Ooh,
I actually nice. Did two playthroughs. I played the game on normal and then again on grounded. So, I'm looking forward to Last of Us 2. It probably won't come out this year, but I hope it does.
Yeah, you're not going to want to hear why I don't like the game, but...
No, I don't want to hear it.
But I am very interested in the second one. I want to play it, yet I'm just predicting the fact that it's going to frustrate me. And I've just wasted money on it.
It has an easy mode, Waz.
It's not easy.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Yeah, but if you want to platinum it, you got to do the hardest difficulty.
So
that is true.
That's not true. You can get the platinum...
What, the first
you can
one?
Get the platinum without doing the hardest difficulty. The hardest difficulty is a DLC.
Well, regardless, I would treat the game like I treat the Tomb Raider games, where I just want to play it, enjoy the story. I don't need to worry about trophies or anything like that. I play it, enjoy it, and move on. But the game... No, I mean, it required too much patience. I don't have that much patience.
You have four kids. How do you not have patience?
Because he uses
it, kids. Exactly. There's a certain... Well, first of all, time is very valuable. I don't want to sit there and sneak through a section. Just give me a bazooka or guns. I just want to go blazing, just take out those whatever creature things there are. I don't want to go sneak up behind one. No, screw that. Just give me some weapons and let me go to town.
Well, I can kind of agree with that. I normally don't like stealth games because I want to play however I want to play. But Last of Us, I don't know, that's the exception. It's not really full-on stealth, so... I don't know, I love the game.
It's a very good game. The stealth parts in it are very well put together.
It is...
It's been rumored all the time to come to, like, the remastered one to be a PlayStation Plus game. Like, every month someone says, oh, I think this is coming out. If it does come PlayStation Plus, I will try it again. But until then, and if Sony's listening, if I have to buy the game, I will not ever play it again.
I think it will be a PS Plus game, right, like, 6 months before they plan to release the second one. But, I will say this, the first game is a bit overrated, though. Like, people give that game too much credit. People say it's the greatest game of all time. I don't agree with that.
I don't know. I'm gonna play it, because I picked it up for... what I think it's worth, which is an entire $5, but, you know.
Fair enough, Yield. Fair enough.
All right, so I'll play it before the second one comes out, but not on my priorities list.
I think we've done enough damage for this week. We all have a lot of stuff that we have to get to. Some appointments and family things and naps.
Oh, I can't wait to take a nap today. I'm really looking forward to that.
a couple weeks ago, I took a nap for like an hour or so with Ridley. Great, absolutely.
I highly
great.
Recommend at least one nap a week.
I can't remember the last time I took a nap.
Water.
I would have the platinum trophy for nap taking if it
Water,
was.
You stay up 24/7 playing games. Like, I don't even know how you maintain your sanity. You play games 24/7. You go to work. You come home. You play more games. I'm surprised. Are you playing on your Vita when you're at work? Like, is that what you do?
Yeah.
Ah, man.
Well, I can connect a controller, PS4 controller, to my phone, so I could play the PlayStation at work.
Oh yeah, because you have a Windows phone, right?
That's Sony. So it's like a mini PlayStation.
You're just awesome. I was gonna say crazy, but awesome at the same time.
Hey, if that's the worst thing I get called today, I can live with that.
We're gonna leave it at that. Water is awesome.
/ crazy.
Everything is awesome. Water is awesome. All right. Yep. So, thanks everyone for listening. We'll follow up with this with our next we're gonna do it in 2 weeks from now. So not this next weekend, but the week following, we'll have another one of these podcasts. Let us know what your thoughts are. Anything to improve? Anything for me to stop talking about or me to improve on? Everyone else was great, but
I disagree, Waz.
Oh, thank you. See, you're disagreeing with me. All right. Thanks, everyone. Have a good one.
Bye, guys.